All right, guys, we are back. I don't even remember what episode we're on, but we're in SnowRunner. We're in the Taiga right now. I already moved my fuel truck down, refueled Fleet Star, and I'm currently going after this curtainside trailer. We're gonna head on over to Island Lake, drop it off, and then we are gonna go drop the rest of the stuff off at Island Lake as well. Start getting these missions done so we can get to these bigger missions and start making some money, because unfortunately company's broke. We've got $198, so we've gotta do something here. We've gotta make some money. I gotta start making some money to stay afloat. The exploration was going good, but at the same time we were spending more than we were bringing in. So we're gonna try to knock out Michigan. Black River's done. And to do anything else with Smithville Dam, we need to do some of the stuff in Drummond Island and Island Lake. So we're gonna get some of these missions done real quick. Well, try to be as quick as possible. Just so everybody knows, this Taiga, this is from the Russian map, so I'm gonna prove its power and might here. She's a beast of a rig, four-wheel drive, or all-wheel drive, and diff lock are always on, so there's no turning it on and off. And this thing, all around, is an overall beast going through mud. Especially with big old giant Dumbo tires. Like little mini monster truck tires. Alright, we just gotta get through this section, grab the trailer, and dip on through. She just trucks along through this mud. In the muck. see she's just making quick work of this mud, just trudging on through. Now looking at the truck, and I'm hoping with this flatbed trailer I can still hook on a trailer, otherwise I'm going to be severely pissed off. So far, so good. Got the trailer. Let's get her going. Get down this hill, we'll go through the road, through the gateway, and we'll be Island Lake. We just gotta go through the glorious nastiness of that map, get to the lumber mill and drop this off, and then come back and grab the Fleet Star and zip on through. Into Island Lake. Mill Revival. Alright, we're... Oh, crap. We never rebuilt that bridge. Dang it. Alright, so we'll come through. We'll hang right and just follow the loop around. Simple, quick, easy. Oh, yeah. Once we get the lumber mill open, we get that bridge fixed. Yeah, get a few of these bridges fixed. All right, let's go. Let's let her rip, guys. Let's kick her in high. Not like this map's gonna slow us down any. I do not wish to go to your drilling site yet, boys. In the future, I will. Right now, we are just aiming to rip and dip down to here. Minutes in, we're already arrived at our destination with the curtain side. Booyahs, baby. Concrete blocks, one metal beam. Alright. Double check. Make sure we got everything we need. Two concrete blocks, one metal beam. Oh, no, 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 no. Almost very, very horrible. I was like, what? They told me I'm gonna roll this thing out and flip it right away. Oh, I was gonna get mad. I gotta be careful because I forgot this thing's way more tipsy than Taiga. Starfire's old rig, still serving us well, still running missions. We started out this playthrough, or started out this series with her, and then she stopped playing, so I kept her rig, and I keep on using it. Converted mine to a fuel truck, and hers, I just, am I going the right way? What is the easiest way? Not really the only exit. Okay. Alright, so hang right at fuel trailer. You got some mud coming up, so we'll see how we fare. she do it in two wheel? Almost. Nope. Gonna do it. We're gonna go for a little bit. Dead end. Just a very bad spot to stop at. Hey, come on, baby. Get her going up the hill. We got an ass ton of weight behind us. Getting there. We are getting there slowly but surely. This. zip around the Souder part, and before long, we'll be at the tunnel. This old girl can't handle. Although I totally prefer daytime driving more than nighttime, but we'll make do. The baby was dry. The newborn. Where are we? We are. Pretty much straight shot. Let's do it. look at a start the game or anything like that. A good thing to invest in for your trucks is a better transmission. I tend to like to use the off-road more than anything else. It gives you a high gear, low plus gear, and low minus gear. And it's very handy. If you run an automatic a lot, you are going to crash your rig, hit rocks, you know, hit some of these trees in this area. They're going to cost good amounts of damage to your rig. And also an automatic, you tend to go a lot faster and you have a tendency to bounce around and sometimes flip and roll. Where with low plus and high, it reduces it drastically. Makes it a little bit lower chance of rolling it as often, as well as you don't really run over rocks and everything and get damaged all the time. Like right now, if I was an automatic, I would be red numbers quite often. I could roll over that rock, no damage. If I was in high gear, you know, automatic full speed, that would have trashed my suspension like a good 30 points. So it's always good, invest in it and use it often. I used to run around automatic all the time because it was faster, it was more efficient, I thought. Gave me more power, it felt like. But watching a few other people playing, especially one of the ones that I watched the most was Arthur Chapman. And man, he's always in low plus. And whenever he goes in automatic, he has the same problem I do. All of a sudden, boom. I got my truck stuck. I rolled my truck. I dumped my cargo. He is consistently in low plus. You see occasions where he will try to run automatic for a few moments and then he's like, nope, now I remember why I don't do that anymore. And look at that. 32 minutes in and this mission is done. The lumber mill's up and running. We'll use the Taiga to see if we can get some wood planks going and get all these other bridges open. Try to make some extra dough. Come on, baby. Boom, a whole lot, 4,800 bucks. Ugh. Alright, well, let's go see what we need to fix this bridge. Corporate expansion, bridge the gap, wooden planks. Can I not take this one right here? Apparently I'm supposed to deliver something here, so alright, well, he's got here. Let's go. Is this. Where do I wanna go? I wanna go right. gotta give some mission back there, and the bridge is way up here. So far away. Look at that, we built a bridge. Cool, we built one of the bridges. I don't understand why we can't build all the bridges. Where's tough negotiation? Oh, that's Hunter Bob's bridge. Back up the hill. Let's go back. Build these other two bridges. That way everything should be open from now on. Another good thing about these big old giant Dumbo tires. They help you from rolling over. If I had the normal skinny tires on, I guarantee I probably would have rolled right there. Let's go fix this bridge up. Nah, we don't need to see a bridge being made. That one's done. Let's go back and grab this wood and let's go fix one more bridge, it looks like. Still one more ahead of there. Alright, we got this. Minor little. Oh, I barely touched that tree. Go up here, let's go grab some more wood. We got one more bridge to do. Yep, right up there. That looks to be all of them. to rip and dip all the way over here, guys. Let's go, let's go, let's go. Gotta say, this Taiga is my workhorse. Man, an amazing rig. Gotta love this thing. I don't wanna go left yet. I do want to go left. Need to do aid the island. Okay, so that I need harbor delivery. That one I need instruments of development. That one I need power lines. Set. I need three metal. That's a log station. Ooh, they got metal beams and wooden planks. Well, I could at least probably knock out this big old bad boy real quick. Perfect. There's a fuel trailer up here too. Go tank up. And then... well, enough time to knock out all this. I didn't even realize there's metal beams on this map. Huh. I never made it all the way over to here on our easy playthrough with Starfire to do all the missions here. I'd almost finished a Drummond Island. Look at that. Alright, let's do this. Come on, Taiga, my baby. Build that road. Let's go. We can zip across the water easily in this thing. Ah, crap. I don't know how I didn't see that. Maybe I should have gone further up. Sometimes these one thing I've learned about SnowRunner, man, it looks good on paper. Oh, this shortcut will be great. This will shave a bunch of time off. Yeah, this is usually what I end up doing. I'm like, oh, I'm gonna take a shortcut. And then I end up stuck, bogged down, had more time than I didn't need to add to my travels for almost any other truck we would have taken, we would have been stuck in there. We'd have to come rescue it or recover it. Just like that, we're through. From us. Let's go hit that one, come back, grab some more.
we're definitely showcased what kind of a beast and powerhouse this Taig is. I did do the metal beams, except for on our easy playthrough, I brought beams from one of the other maps. I had a truck with a trailer, man. It took me forever to drag a trailer through this. I'd rather just do it this way. Okay, what's the easiest way to... Found an hangarite. See, even in high gear, sometimes I'm getting a little too complacent on where I'm driving and I'm not watching. I should almost be in low plus. Some of these ruts are nasty. Monitor your road and slow down for the bumps. Okay. Always make sure you're driving on. Hit up one more. I also like high gear because it doesn't up and down shift so much. It's just one steady gear. Look, there's a trailer with the metal beams. I could have used that. Oh well. I would have needed something with a different, either a low saddle or high saddle. I think that one was probably a low saddle. Power line, and then we are going to be good. Not bad at all. very happy with how this episode's going today, guys. We are making progress, and see how much money we make out of this mission. I'd easily go look and see how much it's worth, but we'll find out once we get her done. I know it's probably going to be like maybe 7 or 10,000. This isn't one of the huge, big missions. Alright, where do I need to go? What's the easiest way to get here? Well, either way, I take a long ways over there. We ain't taking no shortcut, not with beams on the back. Well, let's throw it all the way up, and we'll hang left, and we'll follow it around to the power line, and then we'll probably end our video there. Until next time, hopefully I'm trying to keep going with this and not do it every 2 or 3 weeks, but we do have the launch of Starfield coming out in about a day and 8 hours now, so I will be playing Starfield as well, so I have a lot of projects going, and I got Subnautica still going, eventually Subnautica Below Zero. I'm going to be starting on my Resident Evil series. We're doing Empyrean, Galactic Survival Star Salvage Scenario, 7 Days to Die, as well as an Ark series going with Starfire. So we've got a multitude of projects. Eventually, we'd like to maybe hop back into Star Citizen for a little bit. I don't know. There's so many different little things we could be doing. Man, that was... what's that? Actually, where's this car gotta go? Car's gotta go back up that way. It's opposite of where I'm at, but can we at least zip onto it and pull it towards the road? Get your car later, bud. We'll return for that guy on another episode. Metal beams. There's plenty of little trailers and stuff we could use. Daytime. We're a minute over our hour mark. Oh no. Here's our left turn. Oh yeah. Sign. No one needs to know you're there. Bye, birds. Back and thanks to you, here's a little something for your help. 4,400. I mean, okay, so all in all, guys, as you saw, we started out the episode, we were 195 bucks. We did basically one mission, four missions. We're at 11,348. Not bad, not great either, but now we can do instruments at development, which is 5950. So we did some digging in the swamp. It looks like there could be oil out there. We want to start drilling, but first we're gonna need to get rid of some old equipment that's in the way. Okay, drilling equipment. Oh. And I don't remember how big the drilling equipment is. I think I'm gonna need a big boy like that. So, instruments at development. Okay, so that one's 4,700. That one's 11,000. 32,000 out with the old. I do want to finish this one off. I don't know if anywhere that has. Were there logs here anywhere? Log station, medium logs. We do have medium logs here, so that makes our job a little bit better. Well, that's just a drop off. Log station. That's wooden planks. Wooden planks. I mean, we do have medium logs. Which is great, because we can grab them here and drop them off without having to run away too far. The worst part is we are going to have to import long logs. I don't think there's any in Drummond. Oh, never mind. Perfect. So we'll just have to take a little bit of a caravan. We needed, what, two of those? Yeah, two long logs for Ivan. So, maybe next episode we'll try to knock this one out. Even though my truck is not set up for medium logs or long logs. I gotta see where. That means I have to go all the way back to Smithville. And where's my lock banner? So that's medium. Is it medium locks? Yep, that's medium locks. More medium locks. Log rear. Oh, there it is. Back of the Pacific B16. What else needed long lock? And log lock. So damn. Okay. I might as well just grab them from here and trail them back. That's going to be a little bit of back and forth next episode, guys. So, well. ~88% fuel. You are a beast of a rig, I'll give you that. How are we going through here? We going a long way all the way around. There's no way I'm crazy enough to go that way or that way. Well, that is the shortest way. That might just be terrible. I don't even think the Pacific could handle it. Yeah, what the hell. Alright, let's see if she can do it. Slow and trusty. Alright. Everybody go ahead and anybody watch from the chat if you think we're going to make it across this little muddy, bucky part with the Pacific. I know she's a beast of a truck, but I don't know if she's got what it takes to get through that. understand correct, I believe I thought through it before with this thing. Next episode, and then figure out where we gotta go into the next zone. Norton Passage. Ah, we gotta come through here. All the way. Jesus. Man, this is gonna be a long trip. A very, very long trip. I just want to check, see how much fuel is in this tanker. I don't know if I filled this thing or not. I thought I did. Okay, fuel trailer is pretty much full. Looks like our spot to log out, guys. So I will catch you in the next episode.